Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Trophonet, and welcome back to our replay series in Bioshock, the original Bioshock. We melted the ice in this corridor, heading towards the Daddy Dentures services, the dental services part of this level, and we can see a doctor through the fog over there. So I'm gonna slowly make our way towards that. Maybe shoot him in the face, because he doesn't see us, and now he's dead. It's not exactly stealthy, but doesn't look like we have more company. So, this is the dental services area, so we're gonna find a few offices related to that service. And in the middle of this room, you can actually see something really nicely. Here we find our next weapon, namely the shotgun. As you can see, there's no enemies around, although we can hear a few disturbing noises. But at the moment when we collect the shotgun, the lights go out, which is of course not great. I'm gonna reload the shotgun because we're gonna need it. So we can hear footsteps all around. We have a spotlight on ourselves. So it reloads per shell, and you can shoot in between your reloads, which is really, really handy. So the doctor ran away, so he's probably gonna return. There he is. And they're all melee enemies, so shotgunning them. Oh, fuck. She went through that blast immediately. And that was a miss. Okay. So I think that's a really nice introduction to the shotgun. Where, what was that? Okay, I'm starting to get a little paranoid as well. But hey, so those are a lot of thuggish splicers, so just melee enemies trying to hit you while you just collected your shotgun. So again, a really nice introduction to the shotgun. A bit creepy, because you're alone in the dark. But there we have it, another gun. We already have electric bucks for the shotgun, so that should be doing well against machine and armored enemies. Not that we've seen a lot of those, except for the turrets, but we kind of hacked those. So there's another thing written on the floor here. Adam denies us. Yeah, okay, so that's the same thing we've been reading on the walls before. So there's another healing station here, so let's hack that. There we go. So now we can heal at that at a reduced rate, and enemies that, well, try to heal there are, well, killed, usually. So another audio diary, so let's hold.
At the German prison camp, they put me to work on genetic experiments on other prisoners. They call me Das Wunderkind, the Wunderchild. Germans. All they can talk about is blue eyes and the shape of forehead. All I care about is, why is this one born strong and that one weak? This one smart, that one stupid. All that killing. You think the Germans could have been interested in something useful?
Well, that was a bit of commentary on the Nazis. So that's the German doctor we've been hearing of before. The one with the love for science that was criticizing all the scientists at a very young age already. So did this dandy dental? I think I'm gonna check out this area first, because we can find the telekinesis plasmid inside Dandy Dental, I think. So let's check out the rest of this area first. Is there another splicer I didn't check? Indeed, there is. So I'm gonna go for Electrobolt in a second. I don't think we can enter any of these. So you can see a lot of water. But of course, if I'm inside of there, I can't use any of that as well. So let's go with the shotgun. So there's a turret on the other side there. It's a bit annoying because I'm gonna have to go through the window. So that I'm gonna let it break the window. So let's go through, and I constantly use the wrong button to jump. Okay, there we go, another turret at our disposal. So yeah, I'm kind of wasting a lot of health kits here by accidentally pressing the circle button. We can open this place now, so let's open the door so we can exit out of here. And then we have, a dentist chair over here. And there's a lot of fog in here. and we can hear stuff running around, and suddenly there's a corpse in the chair. But nobody else around, so that's weird. So let's check out the corpse, we can't do anything with it. There is something over here, but we'll first check out the tonic in the corner here. Because this is actually another really cool scene, so let's take the tonic. Speedy Hacker, the most popular of the Hack Smart line. Speedy Hacker buys you the time you need to hack any electronic device. Time is on your side with Speedy Hacker, so let's equip that, because that's the only thing we have. And then another fog appears, and behind us, hi! It's this guy! Yeah, so that's another jump scare. I really like this game just because of that. There are a lot of this kinds of scenes that just kind of keeps you on edge. So, another audio diary as well. So, plasmids are the paint. Probably from Steinman. Oh no, Sucho.
Sometimes I pity the little freak. Such a tiny imagination. Content to sit there with the tanks of Adam tweaking and optimizing. I need to create. Adam is a canvas of a genetic modification. But the plasmids are the paint.
So there we have the first audio diary from, well, the first Vox. What was it called? It's called something, but I'm gonna check that out in a minute. So of Dr. Suchong, one of the leading men of science in this place. So let's whack this open. Then use the shotgun to blast. Okay, that was a headshot, but hey, never mind. So there she goes, and this is kind of a hidden supply area. This is a supply door we couldn't open from the other side. So we have all the stuff here, armor piercing ammo, another automatic hack tool. And I think, no, there's nothing here. But one of the most interesting items here are those two gas bottles. We're gonna be able to use that later on, but you'll see why in a second. Well, in a few minutes. Let's see, I think there's electric box here as well, which will also come in handy. And I drank booze again. Not that we have that much Eve to spare anymore. And I think that's pretty much it. So now we can use the button to open the door. And we're back outside. But this is not the end of this area. So now this door is open as well, as you can see. So this just leads back into the dental services. I'm wondering, did I miss? Yeah, I missed the register here. And more electric bugs, because we're going to be able to use that sooner rather than later. So let's go through the water. We can't really do anything here. Oh yeah, we can't even enter here yet. Just let's go to Dandy Dentures first. Dandy Dental. Another register. And this place is the main office for all dental services. So you can see there's a turret over there. I think that's a turret. And there's more dead people over here. So let's equip the electrobolt, because there's water here, just in case anybody decides. Hi. Just in case that happens. Is he dead? Yeah, he's dead. I think someone entered the office as well. Just quickly gonna check. Doesn't look like it. Wonder if they're gonna get here, but let's see. Now we can look out the window, and we can see a few other buildings, nothing of interest though. But it's a nice view when we can look outside the window for a change. Since we're always indoor, and that's a nice bit of scenery we can look at, to give us a little break from the inside areas. So nothing here. I don't think there's anything under the water. So now, let's go inside. And in here... That's not the turret, right? Okay, yeah, that's right. So let's pick up the testing telekinesis from Suchong.
Dr. Suchong, client Fontaine Futuristics. Work on telekinesis plasmid proceeding well. Lifting objects at distance presents no problem. Moving objects to space, no problem. Cannot stop speeding bullet, but can catch and throw faster moving object. Problem not with plasmid, problem with reaction time. Suchong just get new idea for plasmid.
So as Suchong explains it, telekinesis allows us to even catch moving objects, but not bullets, because our reaction time is just too slow. And that gave him another idea to make another tonic, probably, that would allow us to increase our reaction time. So let's power up with telekinesis. Pick up big stuff with your mind. Throw them at your enemies. What else do you need to know? So there we go. We only have 2 slots though, so we need to decide which one we'll leave out. I think I'm gonna leave out Electrobolt for now, because it wastes a lot of Eve when we use it. I think it's half a bar, and telekinesis and incinerate both do less.
Objects it throws. You can even catch grenades and throw them back.
There we go. And again, I still love these little videos. So hold L2 to grab objects, square to drop, and release L2 to throw them back. And now we can actually try that when we use this ball launcher. There we go. And we have another one. There we go. Look at that. So I think by doing that, we get another Eve hype. Oh yeah, there we go. I don't think there are any else. So now we get the introduction to the gas canisters we can throw, and well, we can get them and throw them in their faces, but I'm gonna keep those for later. So let's switch back to the shotgun and just blast her face, because I'm gonna save that thing right here, and I'll show you later on why that is. So let's switch back to telekinesis. I'm gonna check out if there aren't any more enemies, because if there are, I might lose my gas canister. I'm gonna keep that with me. I'm gonna leave them here near the staircase. And well, I'm gonna explain later why that is. There are 2 in the supply room as well, which I'm gonna get as well. So let's pick up that one. You have to be really careful when you're holding one of these, because these can explode in your face if somebody else shoots them. There we go. Shit. No. Don't blow them up, please. Get over here. I don't want you blowing up my, Don't blow them up. So now he ran into this area, which I'm gonna use. Okay! So there's a rocket turret over there, as you might have seen. I have to be careful though. I can't electrocute this thing, but of course I have telekinesis, so... Alright, I can't... Can I really not hack that thing? Okay, never mind. I thought I could hack things if I didn't use Electrobolt, but hey, apparently not. Because I can't do that with cameras. And there we go. And just like that, we're in another area. Didn't mean to do that, because I'm going to check out the other area first, I think. So let's get back outside. And now I was carrying out those gas canisters towards that center area. No, not the hat. It's always cheaper to drop items. Yeah, okay, not that body, no. That, yeah, thank you. And that's another annoying part of the fact that, well, splicers respawn. I'm gonna apply some bandages till I'm pretty much at full health again. So the last area we haven't checked out yet, aside from this little side area where the Vita chamber is the office in the back here. And I'm gonna show you immediately why, because the key card is right there. So now I have to pick that up, use the key card, and then I'm gonna try and not activate the camera. Can you see me? I'm gonna hack this thing first, so let's start hacking. Because time is actually frozen when you... So that's a bit of a mess, but So the turrets will take care of that if they stop fighting me. Seriously? So the camera kind of missed that guy. And I'm running low on a few things. Not that that's too bad, because I can't buy a lot of things right now. And there's a lot of bandages here as well. So let's take a little look around. So there's another Eve Hyper, which we will be able to use, because we were running low. And now I have to be careful, because I think there's another camera around here somewhere. So a lot of empty cabinets. That's something we can change with one of the... what's this? Anti-personnel auto rounds. There we go. That's something we can change with... Yeah, there's the camera. I'm gonna run... I'm gonna hack it. There we go, another camera for us, because time actually stops when you start hacking. I think I mentioned that before. More electric bucks. We're at 14 electric bucks, which is great for one of the upcoming battles. And we're gonna hack this safe. Saves are always hard, so I'm gonna use an auto hack for this one, because we only can actually use hold 5 of those auto hacks. And since we already have 3, why not, eh? So there we go, safe becomes unlocked, and we have 18 machine gun rounds, 4 armor piercing rounds, and 2 more health kits. So we don't need to buy anything just yet. I am, of course, missing my electro bolt a bit. Just for the machinery, for closing down machinery alone. God damn it, that's creepy that that body is still there under the spotlight. So, empty trash cans. As you can see, there's a lot of empty containers. Hello. Jesus Christ, come on. So, headshots with the shotgun don't actually do more damage, as you can see, because I hit her straight in the head with that one. Okay, so let's head into this area next. Let's crouch. As you can see, there's a tonic on the other side of this door, but we can't reach that just yet. This is the cure-all office, meaning that this is... Oh, shit, what? Okay, hi. God damn it, you woman. Let's go with incinerate. She doesn't seem to care, apparently. There we go. Okay. She doesn't seem to care about the incineration. The fact that she's on fire. I mean, come on. So this is gruesome. Someone's been almost decapitated with a saw here. And she's only carrying whiskey. So maybe, just maybe, we can know what's going on using the audio diary over here. But I'm first going to try and hack that camera because... that might come in handy. So let's wait till it turns around and head underneath it and hack it. There we go, another camera in our favor, another Eve Hypo, which we definitely can use. And now we're gonna hack this safe. Another auto hack, here we go. I'm not gonna waste much time on safe. So more 3 armor piercing pistol rounds, 10 bucks, and 48 machine gun rounds, but we can't carry more of the armor piercing rounds. Which is actually too bad. Because those are actually really handy. As you can see, there's another area here. And that's where the rocket turret was. So nothing over there. But, of course, we still need to get that tonic. Another pistol. There we go. Let's take that. And now we can activate the Enraged Trial audio diary.
Clinical trial lot 44, Dr. Su Chong, client Fontaine Futuristics. Subject is white male, one Roland Wallace. Can you hear me, Mr. Wallace?
Yes, sir, Mr. Su Chong, sir.
Very well. Right, I'm introducing lot 44 now. We've called the name the lot 44 Enrage because of its tendency to... Nurse? Hold him down! Nurse!
So, as we could clearly see, they were testing an enraged tonic on a poor man, and he, well, became furious and started attacking everybody. And that's probably what happened to the nurse over here. She got a hacksaw in her neck. But we don't see the corpse of Dr. Soo-chung, so we might as well assume that he might still be alive somewhere. So let's start with the wrench. And there's another one of these vents we can whack out. And that should allow us to enter the room with the tonic. So there we go. A dead guy. A dead doctor. And now we can look around a bit for anything else. You can see there's a lot of empty cabinets, but we can change that with one of the tonics that increases the spawn rate of loot. So let's grab that. And this is one hell of a tonic, so let's power up with Wrench Jockey. Wrench Jockey bulks up your upper body, allowing you to wield club-like weapons with unprecedented skill and power. This is actually a multiplier for our wrench damage, and you can see that in a minute. And we're going to use that on some power splicers, some more pistol rounds. Because as we exit here, suddenly there's a splicer right in front of us. So as you can see, we only needed two swipes there. There was one stealth attack, which multiplied it again. But Wrench Jockey, I think it multiplies it by 3 or 4. It's a huge boost in the least. So AccuVox, that was it. AccuVox. There's more bullets under this thingy here. Or armor-piercing bullets, and we're full of armor-piercing bullets. Maybe I should remember where those are. So there's another splicer over there. I don't think he can see me yet. There we go! Easily dispatched of most splicers! By just whacking them in the face. So now that we have telekinesis, we can catch the grenades that that one splicer tosses at us and throw them back, which might come in handy. But of course, we're back in the area, so more splicers have spawned. I'm gonna go to this circus of value here really quickly and buy 2 health packs and a few Eve hypos, because we're gonna be able to use those to just refill a bit. I think we can sneak by here pretty easily, because my turret is going to have them distracted. I don't really see anybody pretty close. So let's just head towards the, well, Dr. Steinman's aesthetic ideals and try to confront the man, because we've seen some shit because of him. He's lost all, well, I've been meaning to talk about this, because they tried to remove all blockage for the improvement of science and, well, any kind of science, so including medicine. Now, what they removed for medicine in particular, so there's a grenade, I'm gonna just stand here while I'm talking. So those, the thing that they removed were the morals and ethics that we have in, well, in the normal world, as we should say. So that allowed Steinman to do anything he wanted with his patients. If he had the idea that he wanted to do something else, he wanted to try something. Ow! Got that in the face. So I picked up those pistol rounds instead of his grenade. So they removed the morals, and that allowed Steinman to do whatever he wanted. And we're gonna see more of his experiments sooner rather than later. Hello, sir. You wanna throw anything at me? Apparently not. So I'm gonna hack this thing as well. There we go, they're getting harder already, so I'm gonna check really quickly. I don't think there's anything I need. Okay. So with Teddy Bear, let's hack this thing as well. There we go, another health station for us. Yay, yay, happy fun times. So there's another Vita Chamber over there, but nothing else that's really interesting. This guy is a bit weird, because now that he's served his purpose, he doesn't really know what to do. Oh! He is going to throw something. Never mind then. I'm just going to ignore him right now. So this is one of Steinman's experiments. Because as you can see, her face doesn't look so great anymore. Because he had a bit of fun with her. So let's search the corpse and then get those dollars from her. And let's listen to what Steinman has to say about this symmetry.
Today I had lunch with the goddess. Steinman, she said. I'm here to free you from the tyranny of the commonplace. I'm here to show you a new kind of beauty. I asked her, what do you mean, goddess? Symmetry, dear Steinman. It's time we did something about symmetry.
So he found out that the new beauty model, the goal you need to strive for, is actually symmetry. As you know, most faces aren't actually symmetrical. And if you want to make those symmetrical, you can get some pretty nasty results, such as that. And have to be careful that none of these corpses start jumping out at us. So there's Steinman. And he has a bolt, which is actually sad because I removed my... Oh, hi! I'm just gonna whack this thing. And now I'm really, really sorry that I kind of lost my my electro bolt plasmid, and I don't really have the option to change this. So let's check what we can do here. I could try and take it out. That's just a waste of the ammo, I believe. There we go. It's sad because of the armor-piercing ammo, because I'm going to be able to use that later on. And there we have the static discharge tonic. Ryan Industries introduces the latest in wartime deterrent genetics. Static discharge makes you a walking Tesla coil, zapping anything and everything foolish enough to strike you. Feel safe, be safe with static discharge. So now, we emit a burst of electricity whenever we get struck by anything. Well, melee struck, that is, so we can't actually do anything else. There's an Eve hypo in this little alcove and more shotgun ammo. I'm just gonna be careful that I go towards the... Well, I only have one anti-personnel round, apparently. So let's go with the normal pistol ammo. Then the anti-personnel auto rounds, which will be able to help us in a minute. And then the normal shotgun ammo is good. I shouldn't have swapped out... Electro bolt. That's actually pretty sad. Well, it's my issue, of course, but hey. Let's see. So there's something else. There's not a camera over here. So now he's walking. No. Okay. Just swivel back and forth. Swivel back and forth. Yeah, there we go. So now we can hack this thing. There we go, another camera for us, and then we have another save, so let's auto-hack again, and just open that thing. Some more armor-piercing rounds, that's good, because we spent a few. More bucks, Eve hypo, and a lot of fancy stuff. More dollars and armor-piercing rounds. And that was one more armor-piercing round. So that fills us up to maximum again, because I think I only fired four, and there's another AccuVox here. So let's take the bandages and Aphrodite walking.
Aphrodite is walking the halls, shimmering like a scalpel. Steinman, she calls. Steinman, I have what you're looking for. Just open your eyes, and when I see her, she cuts me into a thousand beautiful pieces.
So, as you can clearly hear, Steinman has completely lost his mind, even aside from the fact that he changed his morals a bit. And, well, he thinks that Aphrodite is actually walking the halls. He is a splicer. He has been experimenting with Adam. We heard that, so he turned into a splicer. The one we've been seeing with the reds-orange-ish doctor's outfit. So, let's see. I don't think there's anything here. Yeah, okay. So, now, very important here. We're gonna have to hack this health station. Because that will block anybody from healing here, which we'll need in a minute. Because the viewing rooms, we are at Steinman's aesthetic ideal. So we're at the plastic surgery offices. And these are the viewing rooms, which is actually really, really weird. Because it's the one of the only rooms you can actually access. And it's a room where you can actually view... Well, operations, which is really, really creepy in my mind. So let's head through, and we're gonna get one of these very iconic scenes from Bioshock 1.
What can I do with this one, Aphrodite? She won't stay still! I wanna make them beautiful, but they always turn out wrong! That was too fat! This one! Too tall! This one! Too symmetrical! And now... What's this goddess? An intruder!
So now he saw
he's
us!
Ugly! 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 Ugly!
And there goes the window! So now we're in the boss fight with Steinman. I'm gonna try and take this one step at a time. Just don't really know where he is. There he is. There's not really a tactic in this fight. You're gonna have to... So now we can explode him a bit with one of the gas canisters. So another explosion should do the trick. So let's try and put him on fire again. I think he died already. Yeah, he kept walking to that oil slick. So that kind of worked out. Trophy earned, defeated Dr. Steinman. So I think it's really cool what happens here. Because, well, he's talking to himself, to Aphrodite, he thinks. And... these are his former patients. So he called this one too ugly, too fat, too ugly, too I don't know anymore. I mean, this is fucking creepy and cool at the same time. So as you can see, he clearly believed he could do whatever he wanted with his patients, because he was trying to make this one pretty. I don't know where she happened. Yeah, there she is. Because she kind of looks like the one we saw in the wheelchair earlier. And well, he just tries to make them prettier in his mind. But that's, of course, just completely fucked up, because he found us ugly and just started unloading his machine gun at us. So hello, Dr. Steinman. Emergency access key, because that's what we're here for, if you remember, so we can get to Neptune's bounty. So let's take that, a lot of anti-personnel rounds, which I didn't even use.
You all right?
And there's Atlas again.
Somebody took care of that sick bastard. Make sure you get the key off, Steinman. Head back to emergency access. I'm working my way to the backside of Port Neptune myself. We'll get there soon enough.
So there we go. Another first aid kit. Let's check out the cabinets really quickly, because there is a lot of loot here as well. And I'm thinking, yeah, there's another gas canister over there, which we might take with us. Because as you remember, I am kind of collecting those. So there's another health station here, which we could have hacked if we sprinted underneath. But I was kind of looking out for what Steinman was doing. But apparently he didn't need it, and just walked into the fire himself, because that's normally a bit of a harder fight than that. But he kind of did the work for us, so not that bad of us to keep Incinerate with us. So let's hack this thing as well, because, well, just because. Yeah, you know what? I'm not going to do that, because if you whack a health station, it drops a first aid kit, which we won't come back to this area, so we might as well take the first aid kit right here. I'm gonna heal, and then I'm gonna hack this thing, because I'm out of automatic hack tools. There we go, wasn't that hard, because, well, the way the hacking works is they get harder each time you hack something. So if you don't hack the saves, they actually stay a bit easier if you just try that out. So that was actually more health kits, which we don't actually need anymore, because we're at 9, we can't carry more than 9, and we're at full health. So that's that. I think I searched all of this, and I don't think there are any more audio diaries of Steinman here, which is kind of sad. I wanted to hear his parting words, but hey, that's that. I am going to take the gas canister with me as long as I can. Hopefully it doesn't blow up in my face, because that's actually pretty much a one-hit kill. Let's see what's here as well, because I didn't think I checked these ones out. More shotgun ammo, and then the same lines we've been seeing all over the place. So, try not to blow up. I'm trying not to blow up. Oh shit. I don't know where the gas canister went. Because this is cool, because they went over the oil slick, and now they're just... Oh shit. I was reflex whacking that thing, because... okay. Yeah, that's all great. That's all great. They didn't survive that oil slick, because those oil slicks are one of the most powerful things in the game, as you can see. Oh, look, my gas canister just rolled down, which is great. So let's loot these guys. Not that they're carrying much, apparently. 2 electric bucks. That's amazing, though. I still hear splicers, which is disturbing. I can always drop it and check out what's going on. I think that's just the one upstairs, right? Yeah, okay. So we can take the gas canister and just try to walk around before anybody else. Yeah. And suddenly we got flashbacks to the airplane, as you can see. Because that was a bit scary. So I think we can... Okay, we can move forward. But I'm going to take a little break. So when we get back, we're going to try and use the emergency access key, hopefully. And you'll normally finally find out why I'm gathering gas canisters. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel. Because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again, and obviously for watching. And I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye. Okay,